Good evening, I'm Byron Scott with a CTV News update. The University System of Maryland is celebrating its efforts to fight the pandemic. At the university's Board of Regents retreat today, officials said upwards of 90% of the people on campus have been vaccinated. Full in-person learning resumed at the beginning of the fall session. Vaccines and masking are still mandatory for faculty, staff, and students. Officials say they've had fewer than 1,000 cases over the entire university system.
Schools have done a terrific job, both in compliance on the masking and to a degree social distancing. There are some members of our faculty, staff, and students who have been given exemptions from vaccine for religious or medical reasons. Anybody who is unvaccinated on campus must be tested twice a week. So the combination of the layers of response that we have, the high vaccination rate, testing that is going on, and the masking has kept us safe.
Other items discussed at the Regents Retreat include the university's crisis management plan and diversity in STEM fields. And here are the daily COVID-19 numbers for our area. Of the 1,233 new cases, 95 are in Prince George's. The county's positivity rate is down slightly from yesterday. It now stands at 3.72%. 19 people have died of COVID statewide since yesterday, and 752 remain hospitalized. As for schools in Prince George's County, 8 facilities are reporting COVID cases, with Barack Obama Elementary reporting multiple cases. And police are searching for the brazen gunman who shot into a business Friday night at Capitol Heights, injuring a 12-year-old girl. Take a look at this surveillance video. You can see the suspect standing out of the car's sunroof and shooting at businesses. The girl was inside a restaurant waiting for food at the time. Police don't think the girl, who remains hospitalized in critical condition, was the intended target. As for the car, it's a dark-colored four-door sedan with tinted windows and chrome window trim and door handles. Investigators say the car may be an Infiniti. Any moment of information is asked to call police. And Marylanders can now start looking for 2022 health insurance plans on the state's marketplace before the open enrollment period begins. All you have to do is go to MarylandHealthConnection.gov. There are more than 30 plans, including CareFirst, Kaiser, and United Healthcare. You'll also get an estimate to determine how much money you'll have to pay for coverage. Maryland Health Benefit Exchange's Andrew Ratner says this year there'll be more savings for residents.
Let's say a family of four who was making even close to $100,000, over $100,000 might not have been eligible, but now they might be for some financial help to lower their costs. On top of that, the state of Maryland put in a subsidy to help young adults aged 18 to 34 get additional help. So I'd say for another, you know, on average, $30 or $40 a month cut the premiums that 18 to 34-year-olds will have to pay on top of the rescue plan savings.
The open enrollment period begins November 1st and runs until January 15th. Well, Metro riders on the Orange and Silver lines face delays this morning due to a switch problem at the Smithsonian Station. It comes on the heels of derailments on the Blue Line Tuesday, which has shut down 3 stations since the incident. The derailment happened outside Arlington Cemetery, affecting that stop as well as Roslyn and the Pentagon, and forced passengers to evacuate through a tunnel. The NTSB is investigating the incident. And you're watching CTV News. I'm Byron Scott. Coming up, county officials are helping former inmates reentering society. We'll have that and more news after the break. Stay tuned.
We know what it's like to go to war, to sacrifice for what you believe is right. We know what it's like to be away from our family and to lose our friends. We know what it's like to bravely step forward. We see those who are redefining what it means to serve, what it means to be a patriot, and what it means to be a hero, to selflessly serve our communities, to step up to an unknown situation, and to save lives. From our nation's injured veterans to the faces of courage across America today, we see you. We support you. We salute you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for your service.
I'm ambitious.
I will not hide it.
We will not hide it.
We embrace ambition.
Women are made to be ambitious.
I will dream big.
Big, without hesitation.
We will take risks.
Not live in fear.
We will rise together.
Rise above the negativity.
No longer will ambition in a woman
be seen as a negative.
Be persistent.
Don't apologize.
Never give up on your goals and dreams.
We will model ambition
for our daughters
and our sons.
I will help women around the world,
the whole world,
to succeed.
You have to persevere.
Women are tough,
strong,
powerful. We have got to be a part of this conversation.
Ambition is feminine.
Ambition is empowering.
Ambition is not a dirty word.
I can think of a lot of dirty words. Ambition's not one of them.
Ambition is sexy.
Ambition is very sexy.
What's your ambition?
To help women build empires.
Help more women run for office.
Empower women financially.
Help women entrepreneurs.
Create powerful images.
Change people's lives.
Fight gender stereotypes.
Equality for all.
For all of us to lean in together.
To transform societies.
Change the world.
Take the stigma out of the word ambition.
Own your power.
Own your power.
Own your drive.
Own your dreams.
Own your dreams.
No judgments.
No judgments.
We own it.
Take the pledge.
Take the pledge.
Take the pledge.
Embrace ambition.
Embrace ambition.
Will you?
I may not be a drummer, but I don't miss a beat when it comes to my monthly self-breast examination. The Edith B. Wright Breast Cancer Foundation encourages everyone to do their monthly self-examination. Thank you.
I dream of a world that's cancer-free.
Welcome back. County and state leaders came together to give people a helping hand yesterday when the Prince George's County Bridge Center at Adams House hosted a resources fair. Dozens of service providers offered returning residents and military veterans, along with 18 to 24-year-olds, opportunities to find job training, employment resources, behavioral health counseling, transitional housing, and much more.
Today gives us the beautiful opportunity to pour into something that has been very important to me. This is the first opportunity we've had to stand up in the county executive's office, an office on returning citizens. And I want you to know that even last year, as we faced a very difficult budget year, we made sure that one of the priorities that we funded was to have reentry services, and we did so in concert with the county council. So
the event was held at the Palmer Park Community Center. Well, another Texan leaves the Lone Star State and joins the leadership of the Prince George's County Police Department. Vernon Hale III will be the new assistant chief. Hale has spent 26 years in law enforcement with the Dallas Police Department. Police Chief Malik Aziz worked with him back in Texas. Hale became the chief of police for the city of Galveston back in 2018. He's set to begin the new job on November 21st. Well, a man is found fatally shot yesterday afternoon in Glen Arden. The incident happened near Aldrich Ardmore Road and Martin Luther King Jr. Highway. Just after 2 p.m., when officers arrived, they found an adult male inside the vehicle suffering from gunshot wounds. The victim was pronounced dead on the scene. If you have any information, you are asked to call police. And police are still looking for the person who shot and killed a man in Suitland. The victim there is 23-year-old Brandon Sellers of District Heights. The incident happened on the 3900 block of Southern Avenue around 1 o'clock Tuesday afternoon. Sellers was found suffering from gunshot wounds. He was pronounced dead at the scene. Anyone with information is asked to call Crime Solvers at 1-866-411-TIPS. Still to come, a local organization sheds light on dementia. Stay right there. More news after the break.
Why? Why take a chance? Why risk a mistake? Why say something? We all have reasons why we choose to ignore the things that give us pause, that seem out of place, that don't feel right. The word why can either paralyze us or empower us to stand up and protect what we love. So if you see something, why do you say something?
I see safe for my family.
I see safe for my friends.
I see say so that they are safe.
We see say for each other.
I see say because all of this matters.
We all have something worth protecting, a why that unifies this community we're all a part of. So protect your everyday. Report suspicious activity to local authorities. If you see something, say something.
Hi,
volunteers with the Edith B. Wright Breast Cancer Foundation, encouraging you to do your monthly self-breast examinations.
It doesn't really matter how you do them. You can do them in the shower, laying down, or in the mirror. Just make sure you do them.
Because this is a serious matter.
I dream of a world that's cancer-free.
I can do this.
We believe in you.
Each day brings hope.
Every day, millions of people celebrate their recovery from addiction and mental illness while others begin their journey. Be a part of it. Tell your story. Join the Voices for Recovery. Together, we are stronger. For 24-hour free and confidential information and treatment referral for mental or substance use disorders for you or someone you know, call 1-800-662-HELP.
Welcome back. A major drug trafficker is heading to federal prison. 39-year-old Arsenio Klecki of Akakik, also known as Bund, was sentenced to 8 years behind bars for drug conspiracy and possession of a firearm. He pleaded guilty to distribution and possession charges. The drugs involved include fentanyl, heroin, cocaine, and crack. Eight other co-defendants also pleaded guilty to the charges. Several of them are from Prince George's County. Rainfall, flooding, and sea levels have increased across Maryland over the past 20 years. That's according to a new report by the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. The organization reports precipitation has increased by 2.63 inches from the year 2000 to 2020. It's also especially heavy in counties surrounding the Chesapeake Bay. In fact, Baltimore had the state's highest annual precipitation with 73.84 inches. Well, we often hear about the news about the ways dementia impacts people living with the disease, but what about those taking care of those sick with the disease? Dementia Friendly America shed light on this very topic today. The group hosted a drive-through caregiver resource fair in Greenbelt this morning. Organizers say during the pandemic they realized that there was a greater need to get more county-based resources in the hands of caregivers.
As we all know, are usually, if it's a family member, they're unpaid. So, and the burnout is a huge issue because, you know, they don't have the support, whether it be by resources or actual physical people that are, you know, replacing them so that they can rest.
There are good things, and then there are other things that are, you know, really tiring. Especially during the COVID because of the lack of the nurses, and it puts a lot on me.
For more information, contact Dementia Friendly America at 301-265-8450. Well, beginning next year, retirees will see a boost in their Social Security benefits. This comes as the nation's economy is being hit by inflation. The increase in benefits is expected to be 5.9%. For retirees, it means an average of $92 more in their monthly payments. A retired person could get as much as $1,600 a month. A retired couple could get $2,700. The increase in Social Security benefits next year will be the largest since 1982. Let's get a quick look now at our three-day weather forecast. Tonight, mostly clear with a low of around 61 degrees. Friday, sunny skies with a high near 83. Saturday, showers expected throughout the afternoon with a high near 90. Make that 80. Sunday, sunny with a high near 65. And now for the community calendar, come out to shine light on domestic violence. The local nonprofit I'm Bruised But Not Broken, along with Cottage City Police, is hosting a candlelight vigil recognizing those involved in domestic violence. The event is tomorrow from 6:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. at Cottage City Town Hall. And that's our newscast tonight. We'll see you tomorrow. I'm Byron Scott. Good night.